Hi everyone, my name is Aliyah. I'm a student content shaper and a first year med student at the University of Birmingham. In this video today, I'll be going through how I'm studying and preparing for my first set of formative assessments during consolidation week. Also, I'll be showing you how I revise after lectures and also prepare for my anatomy practicals and for my small group teaching sessions. It is currently 7 p.m. on a Monday and I'll just be making flashcards based on the lecture I had today. But before I do, I just need to make sure that my room is nice and clean. After cleaning my room, I use my planner to stay motivated and organized. I set out my goals for the day and it really helps me with staying on track and also feeling productive all day long. So now that I'm done finishing what I want to get done in the study session, I just kind of set the mood before I revise. So what I do is I turn the main lights on and then have my lamps on and my projector on. Also, I would have the blinds open and also spray some air freshener around just to get a nice smell. This just helps me to stay focused and also so I'm more motivated to revise. During lectures, I use OneNote to download the slides and annotate them as a lecture talks, which helps me to stay engaged. Then, when I get home, I use notes from older years to create flashcards as I found that making notes from scratch can be a major time waster, so flashcards keep me focused and efficient. Hey guys, it's currently 5 p.m. on a Thursday and I just got back from GP placement. Usually on these days, I don't really do too much work. Like, all I do is just pre-read for the lecture tomorrow. But because I didn't really do as much work as I wanted to yesterday, I'm going to have to finish the work from yesterday and also pre-read for tomorrow's lectures. I also got a SUT, which was rescheduled for tomorrow as well. So I also have to read ahead for that. So the plan for now is just to change, relax, make some food, eat, and then around, let's say 9 p.m, that's when I'm going to actually start my work. So yeah, it's really important to take breaks after a long day because we're only humans. Mental health is the foundation of everything we do, so I make sure to take regular breaks, especially after a full day of lectures or placement. Sometimes I'll unwind by cooking, baking, playing games, or other times I'll call my friends for a chat. It's all about finding what helps you reset so you can come back feeling refreshed and ready to tackle the next challenge. Okay, so I just finished eating and the time is about 7:20. So I'm about to start my study session in about 30 minutes. But before I do, I just make sure that my room is nice and clear. So how I actually study at home, I use a Pomodoro technique. Usually it's around 25 minutes of revising and then 5 minute break. I personally do 15 minutes of revising and then a 10 minute break. You can change it around depending on your needs. So in today's session, I'll be making flashcards from one of yesterday's lecture, using both older year notes and my slide annotations. In case I needed any extra help, I could always reach out to my personal academic tutor, or I could email the lecturers directly as they always put their emails on the lecture slides. Hey guys, it is finally Friday and it is officially the last day before consolidation week. So I've decided that I'm going to stay all day in the med school, so I'm going to have to take my keyboard case attachment, my iPad, my planner, food that I made yesterday, water bottle, perfume, charger, and of course my lanyard, because I cannot get into med school without it. Hey guys, so it's currently 1 p.m. I just had anatomy practical since 9 a.m. and I haven't really eaten anything. So the plan for now is just to chill, eat some food, and then pre-read for the anatomy practical, which is at 4 o'clock. And yeah, I just also need to make notes on the anatomy practicals I had. So today I'm just like getting things done that happened today. Not focusing on yesterday or the ones on Monday. Today's the last day before reading week. I'm just trying to chill for a little bit, but also get what needs to be done today. Sometimes on a very lucky day, I have a 3 hour break between my next lecture or anatomy practical. I like to spend the first hour just unwinding, either by grabbing some food, watching a show, and just relaxing, which again is important if you want to study at your best performance. So the time is currently 2:05. I did take a longer break than expected, but that's okay. I have everything I need with me to go downstairs to the study area in my accommodation. I'm not taking my laptop because I'm not making flashcards. What I'm doing now is I'm just going to read ahead for the next anatomy practical and also just make some notes or just continue finishing off the questions that I didn't get to complete in my anatomy practicals earlier. Just like always, before I start any study session, I always write down the task I need to get done using my planner. In this case, it is completing the activities before my anatomy practical, which I highly, highly recommend. Planning ahead really sets the tone for a focused and successful study session. And with that, I'll end the vlog. Thank you so, so much for watching, and I hope this video somewhat motivates you during university. You've got this.